Okay, this is Lee's Action Figure News Toy Review, issue 86 from around 98.99. Original price was $6, $5.95. You could get it in the UK as well from Forbidden Planet. So I used to love getting this magazine. So yeah, full of colourful images. It's all action figure goodness. So you've got episode 1, Blind Bags. So 99 at least. Action figure news. So you get letters. You get adverts for the Monopoly there. Marvel Monopoly. Just nice to have something, you know, like now everything's on the internet. Those days it was a lot more, you could go get a magazine like this or Tomar Action Figure Digest and just browse at your own leisure and just, you know, sort of, it's got action figures, toy die-cast cars, let's add for the Beatles there. You've got the action figures for, what's his name, Austin Powers, Bride of Chucky, this is McFarlane obviously. Ads for toy sellers, loads of ads in this magazine. So really interesting. Guide to how to make porcelain action figures. More ads, Sleepy Hollow. More of the guide to make porcelain Lando Calrissian in the style of Apu. Old Apu. The Lord of the Rings figures. Before the new movies came out by, is it Toy Vault? I think, yeah, Toy Vault. Captain Action, action figure, you know, loads of ads again. Stuff for the Ultimate Soldier. I mean, if you've got a few of these magazines, you know how this magazine's like. The investimentary page. So you've got the, you know, Star Wars Episode 1, the original version, Jabba's Skiff Guard, Power of the Force 2, $3, Rebel Pilots 3, so Best Return, Minot Hunt 3, Buffy, WWF, so you know, all different types of action figures there. Purgatory, blah blah blah, Speed Racer, the Beatles, WCW, great ad there for US paratrooper figures and German infantry. HasbroCollectors.com, more HasbroCollectors.com. Buying toys advert, the camera pages, that is the Power of the Force 2 skiff feature on that, the Y-Wing, the skiff in its packaging, the holographic Qui-Gon Jinn and Darth Maul figures, so some episode TC-14, R2 carrying case, all of these cool Star Wars bits and bobs. Really great magazine. Comtech figures coming out. Admiral Motti. The Electronic Royal Starship. These look like Action Fleet there. Yep. More ads. I mean, what's good with the ads is you can go through them in a fine tooth comb and sort of see what prices are for vintage Star Wars 12 backs then, and kick yourself for not buying them then, and all that sort of stuff. A lot of stuff about these die-cast cars. So yeah, Hot Wheels, Red Lines. More Hot Wheels, then on to the Price Guide news. Price Guide. Star Wars there. So What was the price of a Boba Fett on a 21 back? Was 1500. Empire 360, Jedi 320. Yak Face 1900 on the Power of the Force. Rhino Cape Jawa was 3500 on the 12 back card. Give you an idea. Let's see. Boba Fett No Circle Wear Emblem Power of the Force card was 1000. Obviously prices go up and down, so you know. Luke Transition was 600 then. So almost, I think it reached its peak at 700. But you know, it's quite interesting. Let's see, they've got the freeze frame. Rike is at 280. More different action figure lines. I Dream of Genie, He-Man, Jurassic Park, Lost in Space, Kiss, MASH, Mega Man, RoboCop, Puppet Master, Pocket Heroes, Nightmare Before Christmas, Spawn, Spice Girls, and some starting lineups. Star Trek, very interesting Star Trek, especially this line of figures, the 3.75 Mego 79 figures, the aliens. Terminator 2, Transformers. So, great magazine. Yeah, great ads to look through. Great art there, McFarlane again, Techno Spawn. That's a great figure there. Ultimate Soldier. So that's been a look at issue 86 of Lee's Action Figure News and Toy Review from December 99, the last month of the century. Okay, hope you like looking at that. I mean, they're still worth picking up if you can get them at a good price, because they're, you know, especially something like this, if you're into Star Wars, this cover's just amazing. Okay, so cheers, goodbye, I hope you like looking at that.